step. I do the networking around here. So we have some green energies at ADM. Namely, it's a small array of solar panels. It's around 200 solar panels with peak energy about 11 kilowatt. We did that last year in the end of the summer as a joint project of inhabitants of ADM without a single cent of any subsidy. Then, of course, depends on the people what they want to do actually. Some people are installing some other means to produce energy, like wind or other small solar panel arrays. You might have heard about fiber to the home. It's actually in nowadays very in, very fashionable to have fiber to the home. It's basically internet connection where every home gets its own fiber optic connection. We do a similar thing here, but we do it in our way. We call it fiber to the trailer. So we end up with each trailer having its own cable. And each trailer or each space is connected to our data network and to the internet, of course. We have also a pretty extensive Wi-Fi grid for wireless networking, which is used mainly for festivals, for people to connect, and for mobile devices like cell phones and tablets. Then we host our own servers with our web page running there, emails, and so on. We have organized this workshop and actually talks on the topic of cybersecurity and how to protect yourself against spying of governments and corporations and even just these common Joe hackers. And it was pretty successful actually, one of the most successful trainings like this in Holland, attended by 60 people, and we basically taught the people why they should and how they should encrypt their communications. Try to get here a police unit actually confiscating our server. I mean, first of all, with this new storage, I'm able to set up an encryption, which is each time started with a means of a USB decryption key, and you can't start it other way. And even NSA and such can't currently decrypt this kind of data. So they can seize the server, but as long as they don't have the decryption key, they can look at it. I mean, they can reformate it and use it, obviously, but they won't do that. Mm. Well, what can we say? It's pretty fancy for companies or even organizations based in Amsterdam and focusing on Amsterdam to have an .amsterdam domain. So we didn't initiate it, but I watched that kind of stuff. I found that new top-level domain in Amsterdam was released, and I signed in for pioneering. And then it was kind of funny thing. They had this motivation letter thing. I wrote there one sentence. The question was, why do you feel you should have .amsterdam domain? I wrote there, because we are ADM Amsterdam.